Shadow AG Eric Holder now threatening violence if Trump doesn't heal. The contemptible former Attorney General Eric Holder has slithered out of the shadows in recent days to incite what would likely lead to violence against President Donald Trump and those who work for and support him. According to the Canada Free Press, Holder poked his head out from wherever he's been hiding in the sanctuary state of California to demand Americans take to the streets in opposition to Trump if he were to decide to fire Special Counsel Robert Mueller and suspend Mueller's corrupt and going-nowhere slow investigation into alleged Russian collusion and interference in the 2016 election. That essential call for a coup against the sitting president came during a weekend of mass hysteria among the left based on media rumors about the supposedly imminent firing of Mueller, a termination that Trump has forcefully stated is not part of his game plan. Absolute red line, the firing of Bob Mueller or crippling the special counsel's office. If removed or meaningfully tempered fault with, there must be mass, popular, peaceful support of both. The American people must be seen and heard, they will ultimately be determinative, Holder tweeted Sunday. Holder's liberal sympathizers might pretend that this is not a call to violence, given that Holder specifically used the word peaceful, but no one who has watched the way the left's demonstrations have consistently descended into violence from literally the first day of the Trump administration could be fooled by that. Holder's call for demonstrations is tantamount to a call for violence. Just 3 days prior to that, Holder had issued a threat against the potential removal of Mueller and how such an action by Trump or the Republican-controlled Congress will not be tolerated. Speaking on behalf of the vast majority of the American people, Republicans in Congress be forewarned any attempt to remove Bob Mueller will not be tolerated. These are BS attacks on him, his staff that are blatantly political designed to hide the real wrongdoing. Country not party, he tweeted. Those tweets had followed a flurry of criticism aimed at Mueller and his team of investigators as their obvious bias against Trump was becoming increasingly apparent. But even that wasn't the first time this month that Holder has strongly implied that action must be taken against Trump, as he had indignantly responded with a tweet of his own to one from the president that suggested that the FBI was left in tatters by former director James Comey. DOJ leadership, do your jobs, step up. DOJ/F.B.I/Special Counsel all attacked by WH. That matters. Support these people who keep our nation safe, ensure justice and our last defense against a real threat to our democracy. Speak out leadership/courage more important than job security, Holder tweeted on December 4th. Of course, the Department of Justice that Holder ran into the ground was also left in tatters and horribly politicized. But if he won't see it that way. For a good leftist activist like him, the ends always justify the means. Our readers no doubt recall that this race-baiting, coup-inciting corruptocrat who now is calling for street-level opposition against a legitimate president was once held in criminal contempt of Congress when he refused to testify or hand over subpoenaed documents related to the deadly Operation Fast and Furious gunrunning scandal. That ATF/FBI/D.O.J. operation had knowingly and purposefully allowed firearms to illegally wind up in the hands of the Mexican drug cartels in a failed bid to push for stricter gun control laws. Instead, what ended up happening is hundreds of Mexican civilians were gunned down, as was Border Patrol agent Brian Terry, with the rifles that Holder allowed the cartels to obtain. Now, Holder apparently considers himself some kind of shadow attorney general, pronouncing judgment on the legal affairs of the country a safe distance from Washington. This slimy piece of work was nearly impeached from office, but wisely resigned before Congress could get around to removing him. Eric Holder would be wise to slither back under the rock from whence he came, lest he draw too much attention to himself, perhaps from current Attorney General Jeff Sessions, or maybe the DOJ's Inspector General, who is investigating the politicized and corrupt mess left behind by Holder and his equally atrocious successor, former AG Loretta Lynch. Please share this on Facebook and Twitter so everyone can see what the contemptible Eric Holder had to say about the possibility that Trump might fire Robert Mueller and end his charade of an investigation. What do you think of the Twitter threats from Eric Holder? Scroll down to comment below.